Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for October the 16th of 2020, well, it is titled Planetary Nebula Abel 78. So what do we see here? Well, a number of foreground stars within our own Milky Way galaxy, and another object towards the center in our Milky Way galaxy as well. And that is an example of a planetary nebula. Now, a planetary nebula is what happens at the end of the lives of most stars in the universe. The only stars that will not become a planetary nebula are those extremely massive stars that will explode as a supernova and tear themselves apart. A planetary nebula is a much gentler form of this, where the outer layers are expelled out into space. So essentially, we're seeing here is the end of a life of a star, and something much like our own sun, perhaps. And what happens is, as the star reaches the end of its life, the core compresses down to something about the size of the Earth, and it becomes what we call a white dwarf star. The outer layers become larger and larger and are eventually expelled out into space and are expanding out, and have now expanded to a distance that would be comparable to several light years. So this is about 3 light years across. And they will continue to expand out into space and dissipate over time. Now, how do we see them? Well, we see them glowing because the central core is extremely hot. That white dwarf star can be 100,000 degrees, and it emits a lot of ultraviolet radiation that then energizes the gases left around it. So this is a relatively short period of time in the life of a star. It may only last a few tens of thousands of years before the white dwarf cools off enough and the material dissipates enough that it no longer glows as we see in the image today. But we do get a little bit of a preview of what our sun might look like 5 billion years or so from now, when it reaches the end of its life and will expand, eventually engulfing the entire inner solar system. So Earth will at that point be vaporized and become a part of the sun, and eventually end up being expelled as part of that planetary nebula, which will eventually spread out into space and become seed material for future stars. So all stars that we see in this image are formed in part from material from things like planetary nebulae that occurred billions of years ago and expanded out into space, that formed that next generation of stars that we see here. So that was our picture of the day for October the 16th of 2020. It was titled Planetary Nebula Abel 78. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone. And I will see you in class.